So we have that, and that would have been used with the smithy hammers, which I've got some here. The days before pre-tension steel, and most of the steel now we do for making is all pre-tension off the rolling mill. You used to have to tension them with these, so you get the angle, you get your saw, and as you can see, it's 90 degrees. You strike it, spin it round, strike it. So you're making like a plus sign. Then you do roll, probably four rolls on there, flip it over to the same on the other side, and what you're effectively doing is cold working the metal and the structure, and that will put strain into the blade itself and gives you that tension. Because if you don't do that, first time go like that and stay like that, so you've got to have that tension in it. And that's how they would have done it in the early days, with a tensioning hammer, all done by hand. So you imagine wielding that for 8-10 hours a day. if you saw with that, how I would have to spin it 180 degrees all the time. And you've got to bear in mind these people were paid piecework, so the more they did, the more they earned. And opposite applied as well. Some smart person then came along at some point in history and devised that. It does exactly the same. Instead of having to spin it 180 degrees, if you hold it, that. Just a flick of the wrist,
spin it,
and you've got the 90 degrees.
Nice.
That made it quicker so that people could earn more,